So during the COVID pandemic, we learned a lot of things. One of the most important implications of what we learned from the COVID pandemic is that we cannot cut up the air. We share the same breath. And to put it crudely, we could almost say that we share some of the same shit, both physically and metaphorically. So let me explain what I'm saying. When somebody has an intestinal explosion of gas, commonly known as farting, they release a mixture of gases, including methane, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, and nitrogen. These gases are produced by bacteria in the gut, and they break down some of our food. Some farts, explosions of intestinal gas, also contain small amounts of fecal matter. So you're literally inhaling little bits of fecal matter or shit when somebody farts around you. And the average person farts about 14 times a day. And these farts can travel up to 15 feet. And the smallest farts are caused by a type of bacteria called Bacteroides fragilis. In fact, farts have been used to diagnose medical conditions such as lactose intolerance and celiac disease. What are the implications of this? Well, if you're unhealthy, your farts will transmit that information to other people who are around 15 feet around you, and other people can transmit their information to you as well. So you're basically sharing fecal matter, bacteria, gases with people around you all the time. Now, let's take another phenomenon which is actually much more dangerous. And that is when we inhale other people's breath, through the mouth, or the nose. And let me start with the fact that we passively inhale the cigarette smoke from people around us, and we do that, we are inhaling both the smoker's microbiome and carcinogens. If you smell smoke, that's what you're inhaling from a smoker. The smoke particles can be inhaled deep into the lungs, where they can damage cells and DNA. These particles also contain bacteria and other microbes from the smoker's mouth and throat. And the implications of inhaling secondhand smoke are far-reaching. It can cause a number of health problems, including lung cancer, heart disease, stroke, asthma, chronic obstructive lung disease, sudden infant death syndrome, low birth weight, sudden unexpected death in childhood. It is now known that even a brief exposure to secondhand smoke can be harmful, especially for children and pregnant women. So, if you want to, by the way, minimize your exposure to smokers' lungs, then it's better to sit up. Upwind of the smoker. It's always good to open windows and doors to ventilate the area. And wear a mask that can filter out smoke particles. Although during COVID, we learned this always does not work. So, my friends, we are entangled with each other. If I'm healthy, I contribute to collective health. If I'm unhealthy, I contribute to collective disease. Vice versa. You are healthy, you contribute to my health. And if you're sick, you contribute to my sickness. And there's a saying in the Vedanta, when we're disturbed mentally, physically, we actually affect everyone around us. To quote a Vedic saying, we are ripples in the vast ocean of consciousness, and it is our duty and our obligation to be healthy, not only for ourselves, but for all sentient beings. Anyway, we learned a lot from the COVID, including the fact that, the environmental pollution is a contribution of human beings. When we were isolated, the ecosystem was repairing itself. Birds were singing, celebrating. Himalayas could be seen from 500 miles away. Fish were returning to dead lakes, and you could see the stars in Hyderabad, which is a polluted city. So I don't think we learned much in the sense none of these things give us insight into our change in behavior, even though these insights are remarkably true and scientifically backed. Let me know what you think about this. Farting and breathing and the entanglement of wellness, well-being, and disease.